Yo, what's up, you guys? It's Anna King, and I'm excited to bring you guys a new unique series to the channel. Sitting around with the guys, and as you guys know, Lions like family, and we cut up and tell stories, and we have a really good time when we game. And I was like, hey man, we should like record some of the stuff, some of the stories that we tell, and put together a new series because I was thinking that the fans would really like these stories. To me, they're hilarious. A lot of the people that are in our lobbies when we're talking. They really like, hey man, that's really funny. You should like do a series on it. So we decided to do a series. We're gonna call it Story Time with Lion. I do want to say that this is an 18 and up series because there is like some drug use and like some like sexual, like pretty much like a lot of our stories are party stories. As you guys know, that a lot of us are older. I'm 22, Pred's 23, so some of these stories are a little older, but I'm sure a lot of you guys are still gonna like it. But like I said, I would not advise any of the stuff that we're doing. A lot of stuff we do in these stories are dumb, and I would not suggest that people do what we're doing. But anyways, I thought you guys would like this series, and we have so much planned, anywhere from like most embarrassing moments to like first hookups to like we have so much planned. So hopefully you guys like this series, and the first one will be party stories, and actually the next couple ones might be party stories, just a continuation of this one, because we have about an hour of us just telling like funny stories and stuff. So hopefully you guys like it. In this series, special guests are Lion Predator, Lion Tackett, and Lion Brax. Those are like the main crowd. So hopefully you guys like it. Be sure to leave a like and comment and support this video as much as possible if you want to see this series going. I personally would love to keep this going, but it's all up to you guys. So also real quick, I wanted to say that the gameplay in the background will be totally random because a lot of times when we're telling stories and cutting up, we're either like in the lobby or in private match or just dicking around online. And so obviously you guys don't want to see that. So we put a different gameplay in the background. And I also wanted to say that none of these stories are embellished or exaggerated in any way. They're all true stories, stuff that's happened to us in real life in the past. So I hope you guys enjoy. Be sure to use code Lion for 30% off Avenger controllers. I'll put the link in the description. All of us use it for feeding and trick shotting. It makes you become a better player. So be sure to check that out in the description. It's Lion the King, and I'm out. Peace, you guys. Alright, tell a story. Let's
Down
talk about
here,
a funny story.
We give all my friends, we give each other fair chances with the females. If there's like 15 females at a party, then fucking like, okay, that's too high of a number.
You
only have like
you.
Seven friends.
Fuck,
but, okay, shut up. Fuck you, Titan, you asshole. Now listen, if there's like six females, basically the way it goes is, usually when the dude's gotta go piss, he's like, yeah, and we all go outside to talk together. We're like, yo, blah, 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 Sarah's tits are looking nice tonight. Yeah, I know, that ass fat, that kind of shit. Basically, we just go ahead and lay down the law on who we're gonna try to get with by the end of the night.
So you just one of the guys
by the end of that, there's like four or five of my buddies. We're like, all right, dude, we're gonna go piss. We didn't want to piss beside my friend's house, so we were like, all right, we're gonna go piss at this tree. We go to piss on this tree, alright, and for like the rest of the night, for 2 hours, that's where everyone was pissing. Everybody.
For 2 hours straight?
Pissing at this tree. Alright, shut up. We all started pissing. Oh, it's kind of crap. No, nothing, no big deal. We go back inside the house to party, and then finding out, I can't say any names, but a girl was missing. And we didn't know where the fuck she was. Alright, so everyone was freaking out looking for her. Then about that time, about 5 minutes later, she goes walking in the door. Keep in mind, it's like 96 degrees, no rain at all. She comes in covered back in water, and she was like, did it rain? And we're like, no, what are you talking about? We had no clue. No, she was like,
was
did it rain?
Head,
I was
like,
I passed
out.
But
we
drink moist down
there. Okay. But from the back of the story, on the other side of this tree that we were pissing on, she was passed out. So she was getting like piss on by like Every dude at the party was like, ooh, I'm pissing on her, not knowing. She doesn't tell her. She smells like straight fucking urine, dude. I swear, I gagged in my mouth like 6 times.
And you throw up on her, too?
Every dude's face, like, at the party was like, oh, shit. Yeah, okay, like, we had that, holy fuck. Like, oh, what the fuck just happened?
Everybody was like, oh,
so
what's
y'all, y'all came together as a group and took turns peeing on this girl. Like, oh.
We, okay, you made it sound like we knew she was fucking there. You made it sound like we were, knew she was fucking there. It's just,
right,
she was drunk at the wrong place, the wrong time, and we had a lot of bladders empty. She was downwind of that.
You just literally said you were there for 2 hours pissing on the girl, dude. Seriously.
Now I can pin it, see? I mean, for 2 hours we just kept going and hit the tree.
Yeah, but dude, she was under the tree.
How drunk is she, dude? Like,
I'll give you backstory about this girl. She is not, like, the hottest girl that's like, yeah, I'm gonna drink a couple beers, get feeling good, that kind of shit. She's like, all right, I'm gonna do meth, fucking Xanaxes and shit. So she was out.
Obviously, dude.
She's
out.
I mean, shit,
okay,
like,
okay.
Most people, like,
I don't care how drunk I am, bro. If I pass out in a fucking bush, somebody pissed on me once, I
will
be out right then.
Dude, but I really don't know. And then we all felt like shit because she literally thought she got rain, though. I guess she couldn't smell her fucking self. Everyone else could. Holy.
No, I didn't hear. Then you guys had to take a
shit.
So you guys
didn't
do it on her too. Or?
Yeah, I mean, she just went right down by the toilet. So
what would you say, dude? You're like,
no one said anything. Okay, she was just like one of them loners that showed up with one of her friends that was already equally as trashed on the couch.
Well,
no one really knew who she was.
Why did your friends come to rescue?
Because your friend was too busy sucking dick on the couch. I don't fucking know.
Her friends
were scared. They ran. They thought that you got peeing on it, dude. They said, this is crazy, dog. We're out, man.
They probably started and they're like, and then they're like, oh, shit.
I ain't about this party.
I don't know that girl. Okay.
No, but the end of the story goes is, I ended up being a gentleman.
You hooked up with her, didn't you?
Fuck no, I didn't.
Oh.
It's not that much of a climax, like fucking a twist in the plot. Like, she, one girl.
No,
it
would have
been a good
girl.
Twist in the plot.
Nine guys. History.
He
was
like,
and
like,
hey, he knew nobody else wanted to touch it, so he's like, it's all mine.
Bathe me with a sponge and shit.
No, I was a generous guy. Fucking, I was the one that kind of told her. I didn't really tell her it was piss, but I just told her it didn't rain. And she was like, oh, okay. And then I was like, hey.
She shouldn't put it together, though. That's the problem.
She's like, oh, it didn't rain. Oh, okay.
So I was like this. I was like, well, I was like, so-and-so's girlfriend wears a lot of same size. I'll go get you some clothes. You go take a shower, that kind of shit. So I ended up being the gentleman by the end of the night. She went to take a shower. I gave her the clothes, all that kind of shit. She got ready. Then came back to the
kitchen.
I didn't get it in, dude. I don't know. I have a rule. I have a fucking rule, you assholes.
Once I pee on you, that's it.
You're the type of guy that doesn't even have a damn decency to piss on a chick and give her a fucking reach around. Goddamn.
Listen.
You
motherfucker.
No loving, man.
I'm the guy that will not hook up with a girl unless she can remember my fucking name.
I've actually had a girl,
like, in the middle of, like, giving me a head, just kind of just, like, dome out. Like, she's out. She, like, passed out. It's the most, like, depressing thing ever.
You're going at it, and then all of a sudden, limp face.
Not,
you rubbing chicken neck. 3 inches. She probably got tired of trying, dude.
I mentioned it last night, Packet. I mentioned it last night. It's 2.5 fucking inches of fun, you asshole. Fuck one.
Like, what am I doing here?
My dude, it's the size of the worm, it's the way you wiggle it, dude.
Oh, oh.
Oh, shit, it's the size of the fucking worm? What, girl? No, I want all 3 inches of your dick.
She was
zero.
She was the apple bobbing champion of 2010.
And she doesn't want to be like, talking over that fucking thing. Are you
in
here or what?
Then you slap her in the cheek to wake her up. She like clenched down hard, dude. You gotta be ready for that.
No.
Get your dick wet.
She's trying to get your dick wet.
She wake up not knowing where the fuck she is with the dick in her mouth. You ain't trying to get in that situation, dude.
I would never actually put myself in it. They fucking, I'm not fucking with them. I don't know. It's not
like she's waking up with an Oscar Mayer, dude. She's waking up with like a Vienna sausage, bro. You know what I'm saying? I mean,
you know
what I'm saying? Seriously. She's looking for some wine later or something, man.
Well, all I gotta say is I haven't had one girl complain about my Vienna sausage yet, so I think I've been pretty good.
I got the same kind of story, dude. Like, I was at this like huge festival.
You pissed on a girl?
No, I didn't piss on a girl.
No, several people. You did more than one.
Just listen to the story, dude. I'll tell you the story.
I
was at this festival, dude, like, and I was super smashed, drunk, dude. It's like a 4-day festival. I was like high on acid, Molly, and fucking smoking a bunch of weed and shit, and I was super fucked up. And here's a little backstory, like a couple days before that shit, dude, like, there was like, it's pretty much like a bunch of people have tents and shit. And dude, like, the bathroom was like half mile away, dude, and when you're drunk, you all know how much you gotta take a piss, dude. Like, I ain't trying to walk a half mile every fucking 10 minutes.
You just go to the oak tree and piss out a girl.
Nah, man, like, so there was this spot, dude, where nobody had set up a tent. Right? Yeah. So I was like, I put my dick out the tent and take a piss in that spot, you know what I'm saying? Or, I piss in that spot, like, nobody's there. So, dude, but then this one night, bro, like, I was super fucked up. I ain't even seeing straight, high on acid, fucking all this shit, super drunk. And this dude and his chick had moved their tent right there, right? Dude, so it's like 4 a.m, bro, and I gotta take a piss. And I'm high as fuck, you know, so I just put my dick out the tent, and I start pissing, right? Well, I hear some like, hey, you know when somebody pours some water in your face and you're like, or something, you know? I hear a dude like, hey, dude, you're pissing on me, man. So I had to pitch my shit and pull back in the tent, and I'm high on acid, dude, so I'm like, I think this shit's hilarious. I'm like, so dude, I hear him, his girl, just raging, like, some drunk piece of shit came in here and fucking pissed on me, dude. Pissed all over my pillow and shit on my sugar bag. Cause dude, they had the screen down, bro. Like, it wasn't a tent like you think. They had the fucking zip down, so it was just a screen.
You know? Like, spraying
you
all over
the screen, dude. That shit automatically turns like a shower head and just sprays the whole tent. You know what I'm saying? The girl must have been drunker than him, cause she wakes up and she's like, "Why am I wet? Like, what's going on?"
You had to explain to her, like, "Oh, differently. Like, the dude knows what the fuck's going on."
What the fuck is going on? He immediately was like, hey, dude, hey, you pissing on me, bro. I'm like, oh, damn. I gotta pitch my shit, pull back in the tent. I'm like, damn, dude, this is about to wet my ass. Like, and this girl took a minute. She like, wait, so she's like, oh, why's my pillow wet? And he's like, he had to explain, like, oh, some drunk dude just stumbled up, pissed on. Bro, he came out the tent, like, ready to whip some ass, though. I heard him, like, he practically took that tent down, coming out of that tent, like, I'm like back in my tent, like, I don't know what the fuck happened, dude. Like, I don't know what the fuck happened. I'm surprised he didn't hear me in there giggling and shit, like, because I thought it was like, damn. they're up for like probably like an hour, dude, like, you know, getting new pillows, changing clothes and shit, and like, because they had their heads right up next to the screen, you know, instead of like instead of getting their feet and shit, I got like right up on their.
Yeah, I'm fucking drowning them and shit, dude. Yeah,
the guy's like snoring, he's like,
dude, I heard, like, you know, when you piss, you know, when you piss on plastic, it kind of makes a noise. I kind of, for a minute, didn't register with him. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? Like, and then it registered as soon as he was like, oh! I'm like, oh, shit.
Yeah, I hope it did,
like,
man.
It took him about an hour or something, dude. And, like, you know, next day, I wake up. And, you know, I'm about to go use the bathroom and shit, and I'm gonna walk. And I get out of my tent, and I start walking, and all of a sudden, his tent zips down real quick. And it's a big ass dude, like, he's a big ass dude. He like, came up behind me, and I'm like, oh shit, here we go, dude. And he's like, hey, what's up, bro? And I'm like, hey, not much, how about you? Or whatever. He's like, oh man, it's a fucking drunk piece of shit came and pissed all up on my tent, fucking.
He's like, what?
My sleeping bag, my backpack. And shit. I'm like, word? Damn, dude. Oh, damn. That's fucked up. Who the fuck does that, bro? Just come to piss on your tent and shit. Man, that's fucked. And he's like, yeah, you know. Like, and I'm like, all right, dude, well, let's roll up a fatty fucking joint or something.
I would have straight
so
up told him.
Up,
like,
yo, he ends up rolling up a fat fucking joint, dude. And, like, we're just sitting there smoking. And the whole time, I'm like, dude, if this dude found out that I fucking piss over him, dude, he's gonna be fucking mad.
No, straight up, because I was
talking about him. And then you fucking smoke his joint?
I pissed on the dude and he smoked his weed, you know?
Dude, no, but the key, straight up, I would have told him, look, man, there's this dude from Alabama walking around here and he's got this thing about peeing on people and shit.
Oh my god, fucking
straight up, you know, and look for a big southern boy and then ask the dude to do it, you know? Like, tell him you talked
like,
to him.
I'm like, hey, I thought about telling him, dude, like, right after we were super high, so I'm like, hey, man, you know, last night? That was me, bro. I pissed on your shit.
Yeah,
right, but then I was like,
but the weed was too good.
Yeah. I was hoping he'd be too stoned to fuck with me, but I was like, hey, it's only gonna hurt the both of us, you know. I ain't even gonna. I'll just drop it.
Yeah, you
but dude, hey, I went to that festival 2 years after that, and dude, it was like a story. Like, hey, man, you gotta be on the lookout because some drunk people will stumble in your camp and fucking piss on you. I'm like, all right, man, I'll keep an eye out for that dude. You know, if I see him, I'll fuck him up. All right, cool. The whole time, I was like,
get another joint.
I tell you what, I never pissed. I always made that half mile walk, dude. I was like, I ain't fucking pissing. Nothing. The worst part is being high on acid. I had to fucking y'all. I don't know if y'all ever done that, but when you take a piss, you gotta pinch your shit real quick, dude. That shit hurts, man. I ain't trying
yeah,
to.
Yeah, I
that,
bet, man. Yeah, I fucking try doing that shit waking up in the morning, dude, and fucking realize you're pissing in the oven because you're still drunk. You're like, oh, shit. Damn. Like, where's the bathroom?
Dude, how do you sit in the fucking oven?
Dude, I was so drunk, dude. Fucking, I was at my boy's house, dude. I, like, wake up fucking pissing in this damn oven.
The fuck?
Straight up, dude. I was like,
dude, I had a roommate a while ago that fucking pissed in the closet, like 4 or 5 years ago. He pissed in the closet. He was so drunk.
But truthfully, guys, truthfully, I have dissed myself being drunk before, but, this is explainable, okay?
For that motherfucker.
Listen, I have pants on, okay? This is the only time I've ever worn. This is my first time I've ever wore pants, shorts, and underwear. Like, all three of them. I usually wear pants, shorts, you know, underwear, or pants, underwear. So basically, my drunk ass wakes up. It's around 3 o'clock in the fucking morning. I am done, dude. There's no, I fucking couldn't make it to the bathroom, dude. I had to fucking just walk right out the door. So my ass undoes my pants and pulls down my shorts and then just starts pissing. I didn't notice that my underwear was still up until halfway through that fucking piss. So I had piss going everywhere, dude. No. And this was not the awkward part. The awkward part is being woken up by your friend's mom when you're now butt-ass fucking naked underneath the cover. You are in your friend's living room, and you wake up, and his mom is standing right there like, what's going on?
He's watching you like, what's wrong with this boy? What's wrong with this one right here?
You ain't allowed to hang out with him no more. He ain't allowed to
live. Dude, no, just think about it. Like, I was lucky as fuck that I got a giant-ass cover that night, because I usually wrap up in my covers. All her walking inside there is walking inside there to see my dick. Fucking go back in that bedroom, get my friend's dad and shot my dick off. That's been the worst time of my fucking life.
Yeah, I never pissed myself, but like I did puke and like I was like so drunk one time. I was like when I first started drinking, I was probably like 13 or something, and I was down in Guatemala on this trip, and so you can drink down there because there's no drinking age. So you know, of course, I go into the bar drinking everything, you know, like whatever I heard on TV, like daiquiris, fucking Coronas, shots, pina coladas, mojito, you know, whatever I heard on TV, I'm gonna drink it. Little did I know that you ain't supposed to mix all that shit. And I was hanging out with this Canadian dude who, like, he told everybody right before we went out to party, like, he's like, hey. I don't drink much. And everybody's like, okay, well, just come out and have a beer. You know, everybody's like, why don't you drink much? He's like, oh, yeah, I get sick every time, you know, we go out and shit. And so there was this chick I was trying to get at. She was like from Sweden, dude, like hella hot blonde chick. And he's trying to get at her too. That's the only reason he even came out. Anyway, so we go out, we bar hop all around, and he ends up like going back because he didn't feel good and shit. And we ended up like walking around, like taking shots. And by this time, I'm fucking smashed, dude. Then we get home, or then we get to the hotel. And this dude, like, it was more of like a, it was like an outside hotel. You know what I'm saying? Like where like everybody could, like if you walked out your door, you're just right outside. Motel, whatever you fucking call it. Yeah. And yeah, so, dude, I woke up, bro, covered in puke, dude. Like my whole bed, and I'm like, oh man, like what the fuck happened? So you know, I'm like, it's like, you know, 4 a.m. or some shit. So I take all my sheets, I bundle them up in a ball, dude, like my pillow and shit. And I go and there's this fence, right? So I'm like, hey, I'm gonna just chuck this shit over the fence. I'm still like fucking half drunk. So I just throw all the shit over the fence. And I'm like, oh, we never see that again. Nobody will ever know, you know? Well, now I go back to sleep, dude. I wake up in the morning and I hear the Canadian dude like, I don't know what you're saying. And this chick in like Spanish just cussing him the fuck out, dude, like flipping out. So I walk out there and she's got this bundle of puke fucking sheets and whatnot that the neighbors had thrown back over the fence in the morning. And everybody was like, everybody thought it was him, but luckily for me, the dude didn't speak Spanish, you know? The Canadian dude didn't speak Spanish. So the whole time, she's like blaming it on him, you know, like cussing him out, like, oh, you poop dog, blah, blah, blah. And everybody's like, dude, the Canadian dude got so drunk he puked all over himself. And I'm like, oh, what a fucking loser.
Yeah.